Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Łukasz Rogalski. I am a senior software engineer and technical lead at CodiLime. Me and my team on a daily basis solve problems related to ingesting, processing, gaining insights, and exposing to end users tens and hundreds of gigabytes of data. Today, I want to tell you about a very interesting and trendy topic that I had the opportunity to work on. The title of this talk is, as you can see on your screen, Self-Hosted LLMs. Before I start, if you find this presentation interesting and you would like to further extend your knowledge, I would like to recommend to you other materials on our website and our channel, including ones related to data science and data engineering. And now, let's start. The plan for this talk is as follows. First of all, I would give you a brief introduction to large language models and open source ecosystem around them. Then I will touch upon hardware needed to run these models. I will demonstrate to you sample operational setup, discuss learnings, and outline possible next steps. So let's start with fundamentals. What is LLM? LLM is a statistical model of language built from an extremely large corpora of data. The model's job is to predict continuation of some text string. Typically, this string is prompt provided by the user. The model itself is a set of matrices that are used to compute probabilities of subsequent tokens. Smaller, more specialized models were successfully used for quite some time. For example, BERT architecture for NLP is in widespread use since 2018-2019. What causes recent hype around LLMs is the fact that these models, simply due to their size, are extremely versatile. The same model captures knowledge about ancient history and about modern programming languages. The same model is able to suggest marketing campaigns and is able to reformulate text towards formal tone. This size and this property allows model to provide reasonable completion for the very large variety of user prompts. If you're interested in LLM space, you for sure have heard about proprietary models. Names like ChatGPT quickly became household names with big buzz around them. At the same time, today we are not talking about using proprietary model. We want to serve model ourselves. And if you want to get your hands on some open source model, you will most likely end up at Hugging Face. Hugging Face is an open source community built around ML ecosystem, and it became de facto standard in the industry where majority of state-of-the-art models can be found. Open LLM Leaderboard is a hub where the most popular models are tracked and evaluated across a variety of benchmarks. On current slide, you can see content of Leaderboard at the time of recording this talk. But a natural question arises very quickly. With plethora of options available, how exactly do we select a model? And arguably speaking, selecting a model is not an easy task. Benchmarks that are used to place models on OpenLLM leaderboard attempts to evaluate model across a variety of synthetic tests. While these tests, of course, have merit and quantify models in some sense, one has to keep in mind that they are not the absolute metric. At CodiLime, when working with large language models for solving practical problems, we encountered scenarios where smaller parameter count models were actually superior. On the one hand, smaller latency helped to achieve responsiveness of the system. On the other hand, smaller models were less prone to hallucinate and invent incorrect responses for certain prompts. In our case, we built a question answering system. In that system, responses should be based primarily of a private knowledge base, and it shouldn't fall back to use internal knowledge of the model. With smaller model, quality of correct answers was comparable. At the same time, it was much less prone to invent answers out of the thin air. So keep in mind, benchmarks are useful, but they need to be put in context of your problem instead of being taken purely at face value. For POC, I am discussing today, Falcon 40B was selected. At the time when the project was executed, Falcon was one of the leaders on the OpenLLM leaderboard. It had out-of-the-box support from a Hugging Face software ecosystem. It also had commercial-friendly license, which is not the case for all of the open source models. We plan to use this setup primarily in batch process, not facing the end users, and wanted to harness internal knowledge of the model. This means that large parameter count model was suitable for this problem, even at the cost of increased performance, of increased latency. All things considered, Falcon 40B was evaluated to be an attractive candidate for this POC. To run such a large model, you will need some GPU. All of the examples shown today will use AWS as cloud provider and NVIDIA as GPU vendor. For the purpose of test setup, I have selected G4DN 12x large, which was estimated to be able to feed the selected model in memory. Since you will be running some code on the GPU, it's important to have relevant drivers installed. Luckily, NVIDIA provides an AMI, or machine image, in AWS, which we can use to spawn our EC2 with all dependencies fulfilled. Once we have provisioned our EC2 box, we can SSH into it and start operating on it. Before attempting any deployment, it's beneficial to run some basic diagnostics. A very useful tool to run these checks is NVIDIA SMI, a CLI tool from GPU vendor designed to help manage and monitor your GPU devices. On screen, we can see sample NVIDIA SMI output. We get our driver version, our CUDA version. We can see that we have four NVIDIA GPUs available on our machine. Please notice that they are in idle state. They consume no power and there is no memory allocated on GPU. This is expected because it's a freshly spawned instance without any LLM workload actually deployed. In the same output, slightly below, we can verify that there is no process which is leveraging GPU for computing. Typically, model documentation on Hugging Face will include sample code that can run inference from Python script. While this approach is sufficient for data scientists to conduct their experiments, for POC, I went for a different approach and used the TGI, or Text Generation Interface. This is another tool in open source offering from Hugging Face. There were two primary reasons which drove me to this decision. So first of all, I was hoping to get my setup closer to production-grade LLM as a service if there will be a decision to pursue this avenue. Second of all, I was hoping to delegate some of the operational complexities to externally maintain software so I do not have to solve them on my own. The ultimate goal was very simple. It was to deliver operational deployment as soon as possible. With TGI, running LLM on your infrastructure does not differ significantly compared to running any other containerized software. You can see the Docker CLI that was used to start TGI, and it's fundamentally very simple. We want to run it as a server process, therefore we detach from the container. We allow the container to use GPU, because that's where we want to run our computations for inference. We use shared host memory to exchange data between GPU devices, as recommended in TGI docs. Same as in any other web service, we expose relevant ports so that service is available for consumption. We use the volume to cache model weights in between container restores. We pull a container image from official Hugging Face container registry. We provide model ID to allow TGI to pull it from Hugging Face. And we shard and quantize model to fit it to GPU memory. In this POC, we use runtime bits and bytes quantization scheme, but current TGI version allows you to run ahead of time GPTQ quantization as well. Once we start our container, the same NVIDIA SMI tool give you very valuable insights. First of all, we can see that our configuration was indeed correct. GPU cores are active now. GPU memory is allocated. It may sound trivial, but during deployment preparation, you may have multiple attempts before configuring your infrastructure correctly, and having such feedback is very beneficial. We can also see that we used 12 gigabytes out of 16 gigabytes memory on each core, which means that in this setup, we are not over-provisioning our infrastructure significantly. We are not over-provisioning our infrastructure. And last but not least, we can precisely see which host processes are using which GPU, which is also very important information in case you try to run multiple containers on the same host. Once we have our container deployed, since it's containerized web service, this means that we can use it by issuing a REST API call. We can do it from kernel. We can do it from Python with a custom library provided by Hugging Face as well. We can basically do it from any programming language. Summing up, this setup is very easy in terms of setting up your infrastructure, and very easy in terms of integrating LLM-based features into your software stack, which as a result can bring you and your business much value rapidly. But what about costs? We all know that infrastructure for running LLMs is costly. If you look at those extremely large models, like Falcon 40B or Llama 65B, so 40 billion parameters, 65 billion parameters. And if you want to run them without quantization, costs are significant. Primary driving factors for these costs are sheer amount of GPU memory needed to just load weights into the memory, but also memory throughput needed to compute predictions with satisfactory token per second performance. So our test setup involved a quantized model and ended up to cost approximately $3,000 per month. A quick glance at GPU offering in AWS showed that potential machines to run model without quantization are at minimum 3 times higher. At the same time, with a smaller and quantized model, when smaller and quantized model is sufficient to your problem, we are looking at much smaller costs. I've seen some setups where 7 billion parameter model quantized to 4 bits was runnable on an EC2 box, which costs around $1,000 per month, which I believe is much more practical operational cost. So, self-hosted LLM is possible, and the basic setup shown today works. But of course, we have to think about what we can do to go above and beyond with that. I want to tell you about a couple of possible avenues. This is not an exhaustive list, but should give you a good idea of where to continue with concepts shown today. So, let's say you already have some LangChain code that uses proprietary LLM, but you do not want to send your private data to an external party. So luckily, LangChain already supports TGI-compatible models. You instantiate Hugging Face TextGen interface class, you point it to your local web server, and the rest of the chain simply uses a new model. It's as simple as that. So what about specialized or fine-tuned models? At the time of recording this presentation, the state of the art for fine-tuning is LoRa, or low-rank adaptation. In LoRa, during fine-tuning, smaller matrices are computed, and then they are used during the inference to adjust output weights. So let's assume you have those matrices computed and you want to use them to serve your model. So there is no out-of-the-box explicit support to load just LoRa weights, at least at the time of this recording, but it's very practical, very possible to simply embed those adjustments into your base model, create your custom, full custom model, and then use TGI to serve it. So with that approach, you have your hyperlocal, fully private LLM, where sensitive data, by definition, never leaves your VPC. What about comparing different models? What if you want to evaluate which model actually behaves better for your problem? You'll simply use the same setup. You just redeploy your container with another model, and all of the code that uses this model can be kept intact. A/B testing of models is very simple as well. You simply host two models, and you allow your load balancer to route traffic to one model or another. If your A/B tests will show that a smaller model or cheaper infrastructure is sufficient to you, this can bring you data-driven cost reduction very quickly. What about resilient production-grade deployment? For example, using Kubernetes. Since TGI is just another containerized solution, it is very possible, very practical, to host it on Kubernetes as well. You simply onboard your GPU nodes into the Kubernetes cluster. You can use device plugins or even a simple node selector to force your control plane to allocate a container to proper node. And the rest of the setup conceptually stays the same. So those LLMs can be hosted very consistently, same as rest of your infrastructure. As I was saying, this list is not exhaustive, but the possible avenues are very interesting. If you believe CodiLime can help you and your business to harness the power of LLMs to achieve success, feel free to contact us. That's all that I have for you today. I want to reiterate that on our webpage and our channel, you will find additional materials on engineering problems that we solve daily, including problems in data science and data engineering space. I strongly recommend you to check them out. My name is Łukasz Rogalski, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. We'll be happy to help. Thank you.